could win his sixth. That's coming up next here on ABC. 45 tournaments, each a fitting competition producing worthy champions. Among that number are three events which each year amplify the pressure and drama. Collectively, they are known as the Triple Crown of Bowling. The first jewel in the crown is today's event, the PBA National Championship, a competition open only to members of the PBA, which features a $38,000 top prize. The second jewel is the BPA United States Open, a unique event where league bowlers compete with the pros. And finally, there is a prestigious Firestone Tournament of Champions, an invitational event which concludes the winter tour each year. Adding to the mystique of these events is the fact that only two men have ever won all three tournaments. Billy Hardwick was the first. And he remained the only Triple Crown winner until 1980. That year, Johnny Petraglia became only the second bowler to capture all three major events. So Bill and John are the only two. But never has one man won all three tournaments in a single year. Today, five bowlers will take that first step toward that unbelievable goal. But at the end of this afternoon, that chance will remain for only one. ABC Sports presents the Professional Bowlers Tour. Today, we're at the western end of Lake Erie in Toledo, Ohio, a city which has come alive with a new renovation plan. The site of the tournament is Imperial Lanes, the stop of the tour since 1966. This ABC Sports exclusive is being sponsored by Miller High Life, the best beer for the best time of the day. Welcome to Miller Time. By ANCO, makers of windshield wiper products, to see your way clear. And by True Value Hardware Stores. True Value, more than just a name. It's our way of doing business. Our night stop is right here at the Imperial Lanes. We've been coming back here for years. The $200,000 24th PBA National Championship. And today, the winner will get $38,000. Good afternoon, I'm Chris Schenkel. Delighted to be back in this vital city. We have a total of 59 titles won among the five finalists today, so it should be an interesting hour and a half. To help make it interesting, our colleague who won here in 1970, this year finished eighth, Nelson Burton Jr. And Bo, what can we expect today?
Well, Chris, this championship pair here at Imperial Lanes 25 and 26 is one of the truest and stiffest tests we have in professional bowling. The left-hand lane hooks quite a bit, and the carry is very good. If they can hit the pocket, they'll normally carry. The right-hand lane is slick. It's hard to carry on the right-hand lane, but the player can hit the pocket fairly easy. So the player who can make the adjustments on both lanes will be very tough.
What about scoring?
Well, the scores have never been really high on this pair. You got five great players out here, and naturally they can break loose, even shoot a 300 game at any time. But really, the strategy is going to be the man that can hit the left-hand lane, make his spares on the right, capitalize on the strikes he has up. And I'll tell you what, as close as I think it's going to be, we may have some tie matches.
Okay, Bo, see you soon.
All right, Chris.
So, now stay tuned. We're going to meet the five finalists in this field. 38,000 to the winner today. Here they are. Our tournament leader has dominated this event like no other bowler in history. Today, Earl Anthony will be seeking his sixth PBA National Championship. And right now, he's the hottest pro on the tour, with this being his third consecutive championship round appearance. The number two seeded bowler is at his best when competing for major titles. The holder of 11 PBA victories, Mike Durbin of Chagrin Falls, Ohio. It's good to see our number three bowler back for another championship round appearance. The holder of 7 tour victories, Roy Buckley of New Albany, Ohio. In our opening match, Kevin Gillette of Florence, Kentucky, will be seeking his second PBA victory when he opens against Mike Truitt of Rockford, Illinois, a part-time bowler on the tour who is looking for his first visit to the winner's circle.
All right, we're ready now at Imperial Lanes in Toledo, Ohio, live head-to-head coverage of our first match. Mike Truitt, 32-year-old professional, on the left from Rockford, Illinois. Kevin Gillette is a 31-year-old pro from Florence, Kentucky, so it's all Midwestern here in our very first match. Well, if qualifying fourth, shooting first, left lane. Crossing over. Leaving the five.
Chris, the left-hand lane, we said hooks quite a bit more than the right-hand lane. It's just the grain of the wood coming through. We're going on a lacquer surface or a lacquer finish.
All right, Kevin to left. 5'10", 155, marks with a spare. We're going to have to be a little quiet here. I believe the PA system is tuned in right at the moment, so the bowlers can hear us. First prize, 38, 20, 11, 8, 6. Mike Truitt, first shot. Nope, a six pin on the right lane for the man that's in here for the first time. And a lot of pressure is on him. He's a fireman, Bo, in Rockford, Illinois. Pair of spares, match all even. This is our very first. The winner to meet Roy Buckley, and then Mike Durbin, and then the tournament leader, Earl Anthony. Little body English didn't help, leaving the 6-10. This is a tough championship pair, Bo.
I agree, Chris. There is no pull area, as we say. There's not a heavy oiled center of the lane, so the players must throw it right over their target. And with the track or worn area on the right-hand part of the lane, they're aiming for that to keep the ball from hooking in the nose. So far, everybody's been wild.
And two professionals that are really fast once they get on the approach. They don't waste any time. So for Truitt, it's a pair of spares. So now Kevin Gillette, Florence, Kentucky, south of Cincinnati, Ohio. Across the river. First appearance since 1982 in the True Value Open, where he finished fifth. And the former car salesman has come up with the first strike of our initial match in this, the PBA National Championship. There you see, 31, 5'10", 155 in Florence, Kentucky. Kevin Gillette. Now he'd like to double, go out to a 12-pin lead as he bowls against Mike Truitt of Rockford, Illinois. Well, things were looking up, Nelson, for Gillette, but he left the 4-pin.
The championship pair working out just as we prefaced at the top of the championship round, Chris. The left-hand lane breaks very sharply. That's going to be the tough lane, I believe, for these two players. The right-hand lane, they should have no problem with.
Did a lot of practicing a little earlier, and all of them were having trouble with it. And continuing to mark is Kevin Gillette, who averaged 215 throughout the national championship. On this championship pair, 224, while Mike Truitt, at whom we're looking now, averaged 225 on this pair. Didn't get a break, leaving the seven on the right.
You could see the ball just slide as it entered the 1-3 pocket on the right-hand lane. He drove the 5-pin over towards the 7, but no such luck. 3-pound, 5- and 6-ounce plastic pins we're using this week. The carry is fairly good if you get it solid in the pocket.
All right, another spare for 32-year-old Mike Truitt, the fireman, as we take a look at his profile.
Mike, a part-time player, actually flops his wrist slightly back at the top of the swing. Look at that shot. Perfect. You see how his wrist is back. Most of the top players don't do that. He rolls around the ball a little early, gets a spinner on it, raises up at the line. He's got great touch and great feel. When he gets hot, he can really knock him over.
This is our only non-winner in this field of five, and wouldn't you know, he'd get a 4-7-10 on that left lane.
The track or worn area, you see the ball in that area about 18 feet from the pocket, takes a very sharp break, cuts three through, leaving the 4-7-10. Definitely a tough split for anyone.
And like those brave firemen everywhere in this country, we David, his best shot, and it's an open frame in the fourth, and he is trailing now. So we'll be back with more of this first match after this. When the man at whom you're looking in that little square, Kevin Gillette of Florence, Kentucky, has an 18-pin lead, shooting in the fourth frame with a spare working. A one-time winner. Shortest distance, though, between 2 points, a straight line, huh?
Right at him, Chris. And I talked to him before we went on the air and asked him what kind of job he had.
Now, this is the 31-year-old pro. He's been a PBA member 4 years. As we said, one title. Double in the left-hand lane on the championship pair has finally been figured out by Kevin Gillette, and he can't believe it. Having doubled now, he leads by 28. After an open frame, let's see what non-winner Mike Pruitt can do. Going to get a re-rack, one of the allowed three. And after that, permission must be granted, right, Nelson?
Right, Harry Golden, tournament director, will come out and take a look at the rack. Truett must get it going, trails by 28, fifth frame.
Oh, how nice. How nice. Mike Truett, mom looking on. What does he do when he's away from the PBA tour? And this is what he said.
When I'm not going part-time on the tour, I'm on the Rockford Fire Department, employed full-time as a paramedic and firefighter. And in fact, I have to be back to work in the morning at 8 o'clock, so it'll be a long drive back this evening.
Well, he broke up the split, so now he has only the three pin. And as he told me, he has to report Nelson at Fire Station 11 in Rockford. And you can bet all his colleagues in the fire department are watching him here and rooting for him.
You can bet on that. He needs a little help right now, though. He's struggling.
All right. This is our first match of the PBA National Championship, the 24th edition. Roy Buckley, the veteran of seven PBA titles from New Albany, Ohio, will meet the winner, then Mike Durbin, who's won 11, and then the man who's won more than any, 40 titles, Earl Anthony. Now it's Gillette, the leader. He has a double up shooting in the sixth frame. Three bagger for Kevin Gillette. Let's see a replay of that shot.
Kevin with that five-step delivery, very smooth, and this is his best shot of the match. He's relaxed with that lead, shoulders a little forward. He pulls him back as he comes through the ball, follows through straight towards his target, a little stiff-legged, but that was a great shot. He now has a 38-pin lead, seventh frame.
Three in a row, the man that won his title in June of 1980. After only 2 months following his start. And his win was the Canadian Open, and he's left with a seven pin, breaking up a split on that left lane that he thought he had mastered.
Match game strategy comes in at this point with a 38 pin lead and a difficult scoring pair. Kevin Gillette does not want to beat himself. He made a smart shot there, kept the ball to the right, got a fairly easy spare. He's going to make Mike Truett chase after him.
So with what seemed like very little speed in the ball, the seven pin is covered. It's a spare in the seventh frame, and a 37 pin lead by Kevin Gillette. Hold next, and imagine a great mile at Ipanema, Eamon Carr. Watch it. It'll be live via satellite. One part of ABC's Wide World of Sports. We needed to continue bowling here because it's a rather slow first match, and while we were away in the seventh, Truett came up with the strike, then left the 2-8, covered it, marked with a spare. And in the eighth frame here, it is Kevin Gillette going for his spare and continuing to lead. 30-plus pins here in our first match, the winner to meet Roy Buckley. 36-pin lead for Kevin Gillette of Florence, Kentucky. Here's Mike Durbin, who finished second overall. in this tournament. And Mike is anxious to get back into the championship, as was Roy Buckley. Buckley, as we said, will meet the winner of this. Then it's Mike Durbin. And Earl Anthony, the tournament leader, is just waiting deeper in the wings here at Imperial Lanes. Ninth frame now for Gillette. Big strike.
Right now, Mike Truitt coming up in the ninth frame has just watched Kevin Gillette get another lucky strike as he crossed over on the 1-2 or Brooklyn side. Gillette going at a 218 pace. Truitt must strike. It's the ninth frame. He has to strike in the ninth, 10th, and 11th to have any chance.
Well, though they were doing it against three or four of you professionals in that last game, they were doubling and you other four couldn't, so consequently you finished 6th, 7th, and 8th, right?
Came down to 56 games. Mike Truitt threw a turkey against me. Roy Buckley finished with a four-bagger against Kevin Gillette. Those are the players in the top five. Right now, Truitt must strike or it's all over. See you later. The best he can do is 182. Right now, Kevin Gillette going at a 218 pace. Gillette's going to meet Buckley in our second match.
You just saw Dot, his mother, his father, Frank, is here, and his son, Bo, and daughter, Brooke. But a game fireman that went through in this field of 360 professionals. This is the pros tournament, the national championship. So he deserves a tremendous amount of credit for getting this far in the toughest field that can be assembled. And in tough conditions, true championship conditions, Mike Truitt will finish sixth overall, fifth overall, and we'll get a check for $6,000. So it'll be our next match, Roy Buckley going against Kevin Gillette. The Professional Bowlers Tour will continue after this message from one of our sponsors and station identification. Now in the second match, the PBA National Championship, Kevin Gillette defeating Mike Truitt 216 to 181, shooting first against Roy Buckley. Second match with the release underway. And earlier, if you were with us, Kevin did strike on that difficult left lane. He left the 10 pin on his very first shot. It's frustrating him, and it'll probably frustrate the rest of the players. We haven't seen Buckley shoot yet, but he'll be up ready to go soon. Cross lane. Okay. So in this PBA National Championship, here's the way it started. Gillette defeating Truitt. Gillette with five strikes, 218 to 181. And now Roy Buckley, at whom you're looking, 39 years old, New Albany, Ohio. In a suburb of Columbus has opened with a powerful strike and a man that has won seven PBA titles.
Chris, Roy Buckley has the experience and he's a determined, tough player, and he's going to give Gillette what all his money's worth right here. The key naturally is the left-hand lane. Buckley, who throws the ball much straighter than Gillette, should be able to handle it a little better.
Left lane. Oh, he just prayed at the line because it was a high hit, leaving only the 6-10.
One sitting at home would say, well, why don't they just give it some room on the left-hand lane? We're bowling on lacquer surface, not urethane, and there's a track or worn area around the 10th or 11th board. If they give it too much room, they'll wash out. The tendency is to pull it up to the pocket. It's a tough shot.
Roy Buckley is having a difficult year. He's not cashed this year except for the Showboat Pro-Am, where he earned $50. 1,000 amateurs, Bo. You saw them here, and this city of Toledo is in love with bowling, have been for years, and this national championship, 3 years in a row now, just proves it.
One of the great bowling towns and some of the great bowling riders in this town, Loomis and Shanahan.
Okay, Kevin Gillette. Well, earlier we had to ask a chance to ask him what he does between tour stops. Here's his answer.
As a former automobile salesman, I look for cars that I can buy and resell at a profit. As a matter of fact, I've got one right now that I'm trying to sell, and I'm going to have a PBA National Special this week at the 71 Carmen Gia. For anyone that's interested, contact me at the house.
Aha. Uh-huh.
He's going to make some local commercials.
Would you buy a used car from this man? I guess. Well, he won the first match with five strikes, 216 to 181. And now he marked with a spare, and now he has that double up out to a 10-pin lead. Roy Buckley is his opponent, a cagey and very smart veteran, shooting now in the third frame with a spare working. He is tough. Oh, prolonged body English, hoping that the four would go.
Buckley will be very tough on the right-hand lane with that down and in shot. He's got what we call a little pull area or hold area. He'll keep every ball stuffed up in the pocket. He still has to make a good, good stroke on the left-hand lane. That's the key to the matches.
So the man that last won a title in 1981 in the Buffalo Open is trying to rebound here. He's 15th on the all-time money list with nearly half a million earned as we replay a shot.
The short push away, very short backswing. Buckley, an accurate player, locked elbow. Now look at that backswing, one of the lowest we see in professional bowling. Straight through the shot, good knee bend, good extension. Just left the four on that shot. He was close.
Still not getting the strike on the left lane, leaving the 4-7.
We haven't seen anybody hit light on the left-hand lane. In the first match, Gillette and Truett, every ball higher. A crossover, Buckley and Gillette struggling here. Gillette is loose and relaxed. He made a great shot in the third. It could be the difference.
Well, Buckley continues to mark, but the man that's hitting the championship pair a little better is his opponent, Kevin Gillette, who leads by 13 pins. We're in our second match. More of it following this message. Lanes in Toledo. Kevin Gillette, winner of the first game, is now going against Roy Buckley in this national championship. He has a double up shooting in the fourth frame, leading by 13. How do you account for that?
We've seen a lot of those, Chris. We said we have a lacquer finish and the ball's going straight at the pocket. You see a tremendous turn on the ball, but not much hook. Watch the two pin. It usually comes back and kicks out the four. It goes around, misses the four. The power on the ball cuts the five off the nine, the 4-9 split.
And odds for the professionals, 3-1. And now Kevin Gillette is attempt. Too much. Too much of the four. So Kevin Gillette, who had that double up, now has an open frame in the fourth, 76 through, and he has just lost the lead by one pin.
See how he recovers from that split. Often there's a letdown after an open frame or a bad shot, but in close matches like this, you have to concentrate on every single frame, especially against a tough player like Buckley.
Over. Maybe that's the answer, Nelson. Get on the Brooklyn side on the left lane, and that's a strike for Gillette in the fifth frame. Oh, how he recovered.
He's playing a unique line. He either goes in the pocket or crosses over. He hasn't hit the nose yet. Been very lucky so far. He's got Buckley ahead by one.
And Roy Buckley, nearby Columbus, Ohio. New Albany is a suburb of that capital city. Comes up with a strike, his second. This one in the fifth frame. Now he needs another.
This could be a pivotal shot. Buckley hasn't been close to the pocket on the left-hand lane. He can take the 11-pin lead. Watch him throw this one as hard as he can. He'll really lean on it.
And he did it. The adjusting professionals on the professional bowlers tour. Roy Buckley with that one.
The action line tracer shows the speed that Buckley threw that ball. We were talking about a lot of hook. There was very little on that. You see the ball take that little break that's in the track. The speed held it up. Solid 10 in the pit. He leads by 11.
Now with the strike up shooting in the six, Kevin Gillette.
Oh.
hitting four pin on the right lane.
Gillette's got to be kicking himself. He came up in the fourth frame and just stroked the ball too soft. It went high for a 4-9. He came up in the sixth to cut Buckley's lead down to just one with another strike, and he stroked it a little high again. Easy spare, but he trails by 11.
Our second match, the winner will meet Mike Durbin, who finished second in that field of 360 professionals. And then, in the final match, were 38,000 the winner, 20,000 to the runner-up or loser of that one game, Earl Anthony. Seventh frame, Gillette. Won the first match 216 to Mike Truitt's 181. Well, 6-10 on the left lane. He has a wireless mic.
Once again, the reason the players just don't give it a lot of room, we're bowling on lacquer, and the characteristic of the wood, especially the pine area in the breaking zone about 45 feet down the line, comes through and controls the ball. You just can't give it a lot of room. It won't hook back.
So on our interesting field, and this is the PBA National Championships, we had three unorthodox bowlers, one non-winner, and two stylists in Durbin and Anthony, whom you'll see very, very soon in our live telecast. We'll be back.
Bowlers tour as the pros travel to Kansas City for the $120,000 King Louis Open. Last year, Pete Couture ended an 18-month absence from the winner's circle, and he'll return to defend his title. So join us next Saturday afternoon, live at 3:30 Eastern Time.
Oh, we're proud of our new High Bly ABC banner. Very colorful, isn't it? High Bly being an incomparable ABC artist. Now, Roy Buckley. Great professional. Has a strike up leading by 13. Seventh frame. Oh, and that double increases his lead, and the man that hopes to do more than double in the next match is with Bo Burton.
Thank you, Chris. Mike Durbin, one of the greatest bowlers that ever played on the PBA Tour. 1982, almost $100,000 in winnings, Mike. 1983, only two cashes. What seems to be the problem so far this year?
Well, Bo, I think we just haven't had enough tournaments in Ohio, but this year I think it's been a combination of things. The lanes have been a little bit different. Some of the weeks the lane's been pretty tight for me, and I've been not bowling as well as I would like to, and I hope to turn it around this week.
Well, Mike, you have a good chance. You bowled well on a championship pair, and a real quick analysis of what you see going on out there. Gillette struggling and Buckley bowling very well.
Well, I knew Buckley was going to bowl well. In practice, the right lane seemed to be the tougher. It seems like once the lights came on, it turned around. The left lane's a little bit tougher right now.
Chris, I think Durbin can hit them both. We're ready for the semifinal match after this one.
Twice a Firestone winner. He bowls well in Ohio. From Kentucky, Gillette spare up. Eighth frame, a must strike here. And gets it. Lots of dancing, rolling, and prancing at the end, about 60 feet away. And that's a strike in the eighth. See that hit again. You see it coming up high. Not a solid hit in the pocket, but
see the two pin go to the sideboard, missed the four. The six pin came around and knocked out both the nine and the four. A great break for Kevin Gillette. He needs this strike to get back in the match. Trails by 33.
Ninth frame, he's on the left lane. Looked like a Mike crossover, but he left the 4-7. He won the first match 216 to 181 over Mike Truitt. Truitt, the only non-winner in the field. Kevin with one championship, Buckley with seven. Durbin, who'll be up next with 11, and Anthony, tournament leader, with 40. All right, almost in disgust, really powering that ball down to cover the 4-7 was Kevin Gillette, and it's Roy Buckley with a four-bagger leading by 33. He's up on the approach, using most of it with a four-bagger working. In a row, and Alice Buckley, Roy's wife, is happy about that.
Buckley, the experienced tough player, just closed the door. He stood up there in the ninth frame. He knew if he could strike on this ball, it would be all over. 10 in a pit. Buckley, a great champion, is on his way to the semifinal match.
He had gotten two strikes on that left lane, and did you see that pin move?
Chris, I've never seen that in all the years I've ever done this telecast.
Look at Roy.
Unbelievable. That is a solid six-pin. The ball just drove straight back. The six-pin somehow got paralyzed. Buckley can't believe it, but it's inconsequential. He's got the match won.
He looked up here and said, what was that? That's the spare. Well, the man that is a step closer. So the loser of this match will get $8,000, but the winner has a chance to move up toward the $38,000 first prize. So coming up, Mike Durbin meets Roy Buckley.
At Denny's, we take a lean all beef.
Okay, Wide World next. And next here on the Professional Bowlers Tour telecast, the Rolaids Tip of the Week. Bo's back here to help you improve your game, thus you will win more, with a device to help you cover the 7-pin and the 10-pin. Watch and listen. It's a good tip.
The Professional Bowlers Tip of the Week is brought to you by Rolaids.
Two of the most frustrating leaves in the game of bowling are the 7-pin and the 10-pin. The mere fact that you almost had a strike is agonizing enough, but if you lose control and concentration, you're really in trouble. Your ability to make the 7 and 10 will definitely show up in your final score. Today's tip is a vehicle to practice with to increase your chances of making the 7-pin and the 10-pin. I've already moved to the left side of the approach. Now I'm going to shoot at a full rack and pick out just the 10-pin. This will increase your mental discipline and your accuracy. That's the first half of our practice tip, knocking off the 10-pin with a harder, straighter, disciplined shot. Now the second half, making the 7-pin by moving to the right on the approach and throwing the nice, slow hook ball across the lane. Mental discipline and accuracy, the two vehicles needed to make the 7-pin and the 10-pin with regularity. If you can do that out of a full rack, like I just did, you'll gain confidence in making these two spares, and your scores will definitely improve.
Roger Staubach for Rolaids.
How do you spell relief?
I spell relief, R-O-L.
Imperial Lanes. Practicing is 11-time champion Mike Durbin. His first championship round appearance this year. He was in the championship round five times last year, winning two. And in our semifinal match, the prelude to the $38,000 championship game, Roy Buckley now goes against Mike Durbin. Durbin of Chagrin Falls, Ohio. Buckley from New Albany, Ohio. So it's an all-Buckeye affair here. In that last game, Buckley defeated Kevin Gillette 235-190. Buckley with six strikes, two on the left lane, on which he'll shoot first.
Chris, this could be one of the best matches of the year. Buckley and Durbin, determined, experienced pros, never giving an inch either way, both good in the clutch, both zeroed in, lots of money on the line.
A re-rack on that left lane, and Buckley now, his second match today. Oh, he's off to a great start. And Alice Buckley liked it. She's alongside Junior Powell, great Toledo bowler and bowling proprietor, and quite a fella.
Durbin, one of the most versatile players ever to put on the shoes. He's won with a three-step delivery, four-step, five-step, the full roller where the ball rolls between the thumb and fingers, and the crank shot. Now, as in later ages, he's throwing the straight shot. He's in contention.
6'1", 185. Just keeping that head beautifully still. What form? We indicated the two stylists, Nelson, especially Durbin, and of course the tournament leader who's warming up for that championship match, Earl Anthony.
Anthony and Durbin both have ideal styles, but Chris, something you picked up in golf and all the major sports is how steady they keep their head. That's so important. Durbin told me before he went out there, he says, Bo, all I have to do is execute. I can hit both of these lanes.
Now the big test for the first time today. in competition, the left lane Durbin.
Boy, he has. The most powerful strike we've seen. And there is Debbie Durbin, mother of three Durbin children. And now back to Buckley, who has a daughter, Angela. And Buckley, if you just joined us, defeated Gillette 235 to 190. Gillette had defeated Mike Truitt in the opening match, as you see, 218 to 216 to 181. Now we're in the semifinal, the PBA National Championship. Wide World follows. Live coverage of the Great Mile in Rio. Gymnastics. Right in the middle of the five pin on the right lane.
The characteristic of the championship pair coming through. Buckley getting a little wide. He drives the head pin to the sideboard, but it doesn't come back. He leaves the solid five.
That after a strike. Now spare in the second frame for the second game winner, Roy Buckley. Owns a pro shop in Columbus, Ohio. Had turn-away crowds here at Imperial Lanes, one of the biggest houses from the standpoint of having room for spectators, and they had to turn them away today, thousands here, watching the finals of the national championship.
And a big strike for Buckley. And a big strike for bowling in Toledo, Toledo Trust.
Our sponsors along the way are so important on the regional level, and Toledo Trust, a distinguished bank, done it as well as anyone.
George Haig and Ed Bergsmark been down here all week rooting for the players. They love their bowling and have made this big prize fund available to the players. Durbin, 10 pin lead, double work. Heard that little pop of the finger holes. Durbin was losing that ball and squeezed it, and that was just the vacuum of the fingers coming out of the very tight holes. Now, if you want to see one of the great styles in the game, something to emulate, look at the positions of Durbin. There's a classic style. Left shoulder back, right shoulder forward. Good follow through. He just didn't get all the lift on the ball.
Ooh, nearly fouled. Nearly fell over the line. Mike Durbin.
This is Mike Durbin's left shoe, which almost just went over the foul line. It's an unusual sole. He adjusts those little marks down at the bottom with either something to slide or something to stick. He says he has his sliding shoe on today, and he almost slid over the foul line. If you'll notice, his right-hand shoe or right shoe is a different color. It's from a different pair of shoes. So Durbin adjusting his shoes to the approaches in this particular city.
15th with that 467,000 career earnings. This year, he's only gotten 3,930 after being third last year with 96,225. Chance today, he can win two matches to pick up a check for 38,000. Earl Anthony will meet the winner of this game. A high hit, 3-6-10 for Durbin.
A dead pull on that shot. Durbin can hit this left-hand lane because he doesn't throw the hook that we saw Truitt in the first match and Gillette in the second match have problems with hooking high. Durbin, much straighter bowler, can hold the ball on the track. He just tugged it up, 3-6-10 across lane. And last year, remember, Durbin missed the 10-pin in the championship round here at the PBA National. It cost him the match. He practiced a lot of spares before today's telecast.
All right. Nice. Covering the 3-6-10. Buckley going against Durbin. Very close match in our semifinal. We'll be back after this. America's Cup Gymnastics, the Rio Mile, Eamon Coughlin, Women's World Cycling Championships, and an added feature. Sebastian Coe set a world indoor best in 800 meters today in a dual meet with the United States, host country England winning it. That's another element on Wide World today.
And that's one more strike for Roy Buckley here in his quest for the $38,000 first prize. The double puts him into a four-pin lead now here in the semifinal game.
Sheer determination. Buckley with a chance to win, and as Chris, we've always said, the bowels of a bowling center, that's the automatic pin center behind the masking units, and there's the fellow who's making sure we don't have any jam-ups. Buckley to take a big lead.
a high hit and avoided the split, leaving the 4-7. Though that's a far cry from the pin boy days, right?
Spent a few times in the pits myself back those days, but the automatic pin setters make it good for everyone.
So Roy Buckley keeps marking. Big 235 in the last game, a victory over Gillette. Gillette with a 190, and Gillette winning the first match over Truett, 216 to 181. Mike Durbin, one of his patented power strikes on the right lane. Mike finished second out of that field of 360. Second largest pro field this year. Showboat had a total of 420.
Durbin has to be the most accurate bowler on the professional bowler's tour. He doesn't throw the power ball where he can steal a lot of thin strikes, uses that fingertip grip, keeps the ball in play, and he can split a half a board almost every time out there on the lane. Right now he trails by two, has a strike working, can take the lead. Closing that thumb hold and keep the moisture down so he doesn't drop the ball.
Beautifully done on that left lane, and what an important match. The loser here, 11,000. The loser of the championship match, 20,000. The winner, 38. So a lot is riding on this match. Here are the round leaders. You saw Tom Baker leading it for three. Gil Slyker, our alternate, once in the second. Then Earl Anthony came on strong, and Anthony Style leading sixth and final round seven last night.
Major championships, 56 games. We bowl 8 game blocks. A normal tournament, just 42 games. So this is the 58th game for Buckley.
Everyone thought that all 10 would be swept off the deck. The 8 pin, replay.
The solid 8. Watch the ball drive through the 1, 3, then hit the 5. Now the ball's supposed to deflect and over and hit the 9. It did, but the 8 pin was left alone as the ball took the 5 straight back. A freak hit.
Okay, Roy Buckley. We asked what prompted him to retire as a full-time touring pro. What he's doing now?
Well, right now I'm working in a pro shop. I open up my own shop at home. I just spent too many weeks out here on the road. Just kind of burned myself out. So I thought I would get into a different area, maybe diversify myself into different phases of the game. So I'm teaching bowling, drilling bowling balls, and just kind of being a part-time touring player.
Well, part-time got him into the third position today, and he won the last match with a 235, and now he has a 4-pin on that pesky left lane, and he's shooting here in the 7th frame. He's 39 years old. Winner of 7 titles, 14 years a member of the PBA, which this year is celebrating its 25th. We'll be back. Crown the PBA National Championship. Total of 200,000, 38,000 of the winner. That'll come in the next match. Mike Durbin, who finished second overall, going against Roy Buckley. Durbin, leading by 10, can increase it to 20. Double working. He's shooting in the 7th frame. All right, a little comfort there with his 3-bagger now here in the semifinal game.
Durbin going directly towards the pocket, as you see from a rear view through the pin deck. Durbin solid into 1-3. The ball hits the 5, the 9. 6-pin takes out the 10. They're on the left-hand part of your screen. Durbin, 20-pin lead. Turkey working. He can really put it to Buckley with another strike here in the 8th.
Debbie Durbin is hoping. Mike really taking his time. Stepped off the approach now. Mike, the president of the Professional Bowlers Association. Competitor, Mike Durbin, and there you see Matthew and his mom.
Durbin in a must situation right now. Buck Durbin at a 236 pace, Buckley at a 206. Buckley still has room for 236 with some strikes.
There's one. Eighth frame. Very important day for both Roy Buckley and Mike Durbin because they haven't gone to the well money-wise this year like they normally do. Especially Durbin. Last year, 96,000. This year, just under four. Whereas Buckley has earned $50 this year. Oh, your fellow professionals are tremendous when the heat's on. Pressure here in the championship.
Roy Buckley so good in the clutch. He's looking up at the scoreboard. He realizes he's trailing by 20 pins. If Durbin doesn't shut him out here in the ninth and 10th, Buckley will come up in the 10th frame with a chance to take it all. But right now, Durbin has the control of the match. Ninth frame, he's working on a four-bagger.
A deep breath. Even though it seemed to slide by, gets it.
The situation for Durbin after he carried that strike in the ninth frame is simply this. He must mark in the 10th. If he strikes or spares in the 10th frame, he wins the match and will go against tournament leader Earl Anthony. If he opens, Buckley can throw two strikes and still take it all.
Seven on the left lane. Now he needs to cover them.
Durbin testing the approach. He has a split pair of shoes on, one for sliding, one for grabbing. But Durbin got a great break there in the 10th frame. He almost left the 4-7-10 split, broke out the 10 pin. All he needs to do is convert this 4-7, and he'll go on to meet Anthony.
Anxious moments at the line, but marked. Buckley gets off the settee to sort of limber up those legs a little bit.
Durbin has to guard against the foul. We've seen him slip twice up there. He just needs to keep the ball in the lane to win the match.
So Mike Durbin, the 11-time champion, twice a Firestone winner, has come through with the strike and the marks when he needed them. Buckley. 10 pin, Buckley having won the previous game, 235-190. Very, very disappointed. But for him, it will be $11,000. And we go into that final match where the total is $58,000. It's a total at stake. And Earl Anthony will have to test Mike Durbin. There's Durbin, the winner of our semifinal game. Durbin with a 244. Buckley will be in the two teens. So with Durbin meeting Anthony, the professional bowlers tour will continue after this message and station identification. Back live, capacity crowd stretching their legs because at stake, the single match for the PBA National Championship, Earl Anthony, the tournament leader, going against the man who finished second, Mike Durbin, who just defeated Roy Buckley 244-213. And, Bo, what about 6 through 24?
Chris, there was 90 cashers, 24 of them made the top 24. Sliker just missed, Sutar and myself just missed out in the last frame. Alvin Liu, a good week, veteran Les Schisler, the 300 king of the PBA, Steve Wunderlich in 11th. Regional Pro Colosi, Ted Hennins on the Firestone bottle, Wagner, Tom Baker, early lead and failed a little bit in the finals. Sofer and Flanagan, the great Marshall Holman in 18th. Lefty Paul Moser, veteran Tita Semez, Mark Baker, a name to look for, Jim Murshaw bowled well, Tony Acosta tore him up, and Jimmy Miller round out the top 24 out of a 360-man field.
Thanks, Nelson. We're here at the Imperial Lanes in Toledo, Ohio, waiting the start of the championship match for the PBA national title. First, though, let's hear from our colleague, Frank Gifford.
Thank you, Chris. We'll do this.
Thank you, Frank. And in the striped shirt at the left side, that is the 40-time winner, incomparable Earl Anthony, the tournament leader, who'll be going against Mike Durbin, who just had a victory over Roy Buckley. And Earl loves it here in Toledo Imperial Lanes. Two PBA National Championships back-to-back, 81 and 82. In 1981, he was top-seeded. He was looking for his 35th PBA title. He defeated the flamboyant Ernie Schlegel, 242 to 237. The top prize then was $21,000. His third PBA title. A year later, last year, Earl was again top-seeded. He defeated Charlie Tapp in that game, 233 to 191, and it was his 38th career title. What a history, this man that went over a million here at Imperial. We asked him why he likes this.
The U.S. Open, but to me, the national championship is just exactly what it says it is, the PBA National Championship. It's always something I've pumped up for, and it's always been, since I've been on the tour, to me, the number one title in bowling. So I just seem to do my best in this tournament for some reason. I guess it's because I want to win it more than any other event we have.
Well, he's won two here, five total PBA National Championships. Would like to make it three in a row and his sixth. And the big thing, Bo, last year was when he went over the million mark right here on these lanes. And Chris, now our final match.
As the final match comes up, Chris, the $38,000 first prize. I don't think in professional bowling on these particular conditions in this situation that I would ever see two tougher players. You can put Holman in that group, Wayne Webb in that group, Roth in that group, but Durbin and Earl Anthony, experienced players, both over the age of 40. They know what it's all about. They won't give it away. This is going to be one of the great matches.
Mike Durbin, 244 in his last game. Coming up high, practically crossing over, and he's going to have to knock down the seven pin on that left lane.
Just testing Earl's side there. Maybe a little psychology to start the match, but in essence, Mike, with a little five-minute wait in between matches, went up there, just pulled the ball slightly. He was so disciplined in the last match. First frame, he has an easy spare.
All right, Mike Durbin, semifinal game winner, was marked with a spare in the first frame in this title match. Now Earl Anthony, whose very presence puts pressure on the opponent. Then he steps up on the approaches, as he has in winning 40 times, and gets the job done. First stroke. And it's a seven pin for Earl on the right lane of this championship pair.
For Earl Anthony, he says the right-hand lane hooks a little bit more than the left-hand lane, and the only difference that the right-handed bowlers have is that there's more wear on the left-hand lane, so Earl has to guard against hooking too much on this particular lane. He says he likes the stiff lane. That's the lane he'll finish on in the 10th frame.
Earl Anthony, the left-hander, the only one in this field of five in the national championship as we replay his shot.
Very much like Mike Durbin, takes that five-step delivery, low backswing, shoulders in great position. Watch how he rotates that right shoulder back as the left shoulder comes through. Deep knee bend, excellent follow-through. That ball was in the pocket.
Because of a knee problem, wearing a brace on his right knee, Earl Anthony. No way offering that as an excuse. He is a great champion. A high hit on that left lane, and it's a 4-7-10, and Susie Anthony
he knows he can't give Durbin much room, and as he pointed the ball up towards the pocket to compensate for the slicker left-hand lane, just went too straight at the 1-2 pocket, has the 4-7-10 split.
So it's an open frame for Earl Anthony. Earl's the type like Jack Nicklaus. When he misses something, they're almost totally embarrassed. They just are such perfectionists.
Mike Durbin, a tough man to open the door against. Since 1979, Chris, he has 20 wins and 4 losses in the championship round, so he's not used to losing any matches.
Bye, bye. And it's a 10-pin on the right lane from Mike Durbin, who's won two Firestone Tournament of Champions, the third jewel in bowling's Triple Crown, this, the PBA being the first. And he did it 10 years apart, one last year and 10 years prior to that, won his first. Now cross lane on the right side for the 10-pin.
Durbin with that methodical four-step delivery. As you see, not a match pair of shoes, but he adjusts his shoes every week to the approaches that we have on the tour. Watch him pivot off that dark shoe, the tip of the right foot, driving through. See his left foot slide under the center of the body, and see those shoulders and knee all in line with the foot. Perfect form.
Well, the few times you can wear different shoes without somebody thinking you're a little strange.
He won't be strange with 38,000 in his pocket if he wins this match.
Okay. Oh, shots like that. You saw a couple of hits like that in the semifinal match. Powerful bowling ball. It's his strike, his first of this title match, coming in the third frame. Now Earl Anthony had an open in the second, 25 through the second, trailing by 14, now shooting in the third on the right lane.
Saw the 4-9 for the right-hander in that lane in match two, and here for Earl Anthony, we see the 6-8. The ball breaks very sharply, cutting through the 1-2 pocket. The 3-pin goes to sideboard. Normally would take out the 6 and drive it into the 8-pin. No such luck. Earl has another difficult split.
Look at that. That's what champions are made of. Fantastic.
The picture speaks for itself. Earl Anthony with a precision shot under pressure. And as Bob Rykoff, the manager, said here, he put on 7 coats of lacquer so the ball would roll true. Earl Anthony took advantage of that true roll, Chris, and slid the 6 into the 8. He only trails by 14, got the tough 3 frames out of his way.
Now he's on the left lane. 4th frame. Probably pumped up too much adrenaline, Bob.
Well, he said the left-hand lane was so slick, and here is ball cutting right on through. He's pointing it up at the nose. He leaves the 2-7 baby split. Let's see if he can convert that one. The 6-8 he just made in the third frame is much more difficult, but frame after frame he's under pressure. Let's see how he responds.
Early here in the match, it's going to be a well-earned victory. So for Earl Anthony, shooting for his 6th PBA National Championship, it's his 2nd open frame after converting the 6-8 in the third. More of this match from Toledo following this. Falls, Ohio, an 11-time champion, has had the door opened again by Earl Anthony. Durbin with a strike up in the third, shooting in the fourth, leading by 27. He had it, a 10-pin.
He really wanted that one. Earl Anthony's greatness speaks for itself. Durbin, no slouch, really wanted to put Anthony away. It's very much like a football game. When you can score a lot of touchdowns in the first half, you better get them because you might need them in the second half. The match is still wide open.
All right. Mike Durbin continuing to mark here in the championship match. 24th PBA National Championship. Third year in a row here in Toledo, Ohio at Imperial Lanes.
And here's the action that Nelson Burton and Chris Schenkel see the action from.
Mm-hmm. Billy Sullivan, our roving cameraman, one of the best in the business. Mike Durbin on the left lane. 4-9, so he has his problems.
Exact same thing that happened to Earl Anthony, except it happened to the right-hander, Mike Durbin, the 4-9, pointing the ball up into the pocket. The ball cuts through so sharply, leaves the 4-9. He has to do the same thing, the 4-pin that Earl Anthony did to the 6, slide it over.
Needless to say, went all out for it. So for Mike Durbin, it's his first open coming in the fifth frame, and Anthony now trails by only 13. 52 through 4, shooting in the fifth. Little adjustment. Piece of debris down at the far end, removed by one of the workers here, and Anthony now is ready. Cheering with the crowd. Well, that's strike. The first in 5 frames for Anthony, who led the last 2 rounds of this championship. Sort of walked away from the field, but not against Durbin.
He made the adjustment on the high hit he had in the 4th frame and the high hit he had in the 2nd frame. He blew the 5 out. He's now in position to cut Mike Durbin's lead from 13 down to 3. And this is really an important shot for Earl, because Durbin needs to feel some pressure. Earl needs to build a little confidence. They're coming down to the last 5 frames.
Anthony, the top average leader thus far this year, a little over 217. Taking out the 5, leaving only the 10.
Earl confused on the left-hand lane. As Earl's ball is coming into the pocket right here, he expects to drive the 5-pin over into the 10-pin. It doesn't happen. So the ball doesn't do the job.
Smooth delivery, as usual. Earl Anthony covering the 10. 2 stylists. Perhaps you can compare your own to a degree with these two, a right-hander and a left-hander, both 6'1". Durbin, at whom we're looking, 185, and Anthony, 190 pounds. A 4.
Almost the same hit that he had in the 5th frame. Durbin drives the ball high into the pocket. You see the ball enter the 1-3, take out the 5 and the 9. You see on the previous shot, the 5-pin and the 9 didn't go out together. The 2-pin didn't trip the 4. An easy spare for Durbin. He'll maintain his 13-pin lead.
The emotional drain here will make it a well-earned, hard-earned victory for both professionals. Anthony with 2 open frames, Durbin with 1, 13-pin trailing. Anthony trailing Durbin at this point. 38,000 to the winner, 20,000 to the runner-up. Sure, he had them all.
Exactly right, Chris. Unexpected solid 10. The ball drives right straight into the 1-3 pocket right here. But watch the 6-pin as it flies around the 10-pin and leaves a solid 10. Durbin thought he had it. And there it is.
Cross lane. Okay. Durbin in a very tight championship match. 12 pins separating these two. Anthony now will be shooting in the 7th frame with a spare up. Earlier, Kevin Gillette defeated Mike Truitt 216 to 181. Roy Buckley defeated Gillette 235 to 190. And then Durbin defeated Buckley 244 to 213. Next week, it's the King Louis Open in Overland Park, Kansas. That strike, Bo, was not difficult.
Right in the pocket, seventh frame. Anthony coming up in the eighth. This is the most important shot that Anthony's thrown all week. He started last Sunday, 6 days ago, and right now he's on a lane he's confused on. He'll have to strike here in the eighth to cut the lead down to two. If he doesn't, he'll still need to hit this lane in the tenth. Let's see what he does.
And did it. A delayed strike on the tough left lane for Earl Anthony, and his double has cut Mike Durbin's lead to two.
Anthony gets a break. He just keeps it in play. We say accuracy is 95% of the game. The head pin goes to the sideboard, drives the six into the 10. The head pin comes around and gets the five. Anthony has closed the match down to just two pins. We're coming down to the eighth, ninth, and 10th.
Now Durbin, eighth frame, spare working. Strike just as powerful and loud as Anthony's.
Crucial frame for Mike. He maintains his lead, but he also gets the strike up so that he can control the match. Even if he doesn't strike on this ball, he still has the lead. The pin count tells the story. Durbin, two-pin lead. Wide world. 10th frame, Chris.
Wide World is next. American Cup Gymnastics. The Real Mile, Eamon Cogburn. Women's World Cycling Championships in an added event. Sebastian Coe setting world indoor best in 800 meters, leading his team, England, against the United States in a dual meet. That's next. Oh, a high hit, a good break, leaving the six, and I think Mike stuck a little at the line.
His heel caught just a little bit as he let go of the ball, but he thought he had good direction. But once again, it caught that tracker worn spot that the right-handers have from all the play over the years and jumped high. He avoided the 4-6 split, has an easy spare to maintain his lead through nine frames.
Debbie Durbin, this is the championship match and the type of competition we've been accustomed to here on ABC. And you know, there was a sparkling event at the Waldorf on Wednesday night, Bo. Our president of ABC News and Sports, Rune Arledge, received a much sought-after gold medal awarded by the International Radio and Television Society for distinguished service to the broadcasting industry. What's good about it, we've been able to look on and watch him do it.
Congratulations. Key right. Shot for Anthony.
Look at that. And as Rune Arledge would say, incredible. Eight-pin lead now, Anthony.
He needed that one to take the lead, and what was so important about it, not only to take the lead, but he has not zeroed in on this lane he's coming up on in the 10th frame. Anthony doesn't muscle the ball very much, although he's a powerful man. He's a stroker. He just leaned back and just threw that ball in the style of Roy Buckley, solid in the pocket. Anthony right now can close out Durbin with another strike.
Here he is. Earl Anthony.
Earl Anthony just has to stay behind the foul line. He's going at a 2:02 pace, the best Durbin can shoot his 194. Just keep it on the lane.
Earl Anthony, who's making his third consecutive appearance, winning the True Value Open 2 weeks ago. And it is his sixth PBA National Championship, his 41st PBA title, and against a great winner, Mike Durbin. What a finish. Earl Anthony over Mike Durbin. 38,000 to Anthony, 20,000 to Mike Durbin. A hug from Bob Raycroft.
More to John's
sixth PBA national title, a 210 to Mike Durbin's 183, setting up the second jewel, the open, and then the Firestone. That's George Haig on the right, president of the Toledo Trust. Earl Anthony, a check for $38,000. The coat, emblematic of winning again, Joe Antonora, the commissioner of the PBA. So, once again, the winner, Earl Anthony, 210 to Durbin's 183. Coming up next, ABC's Wide World of Sports featuring American Cup Gymnastics from New York. The Real Mile via satellite from Rio de Janeiro. The Women's World Cycling Championships from England. An added feature, Sebastian Coe and a great 800-meter performance, the world's best indoor in the England-United States dual meet. Travel arrangements made through and a promotional fee paid by United Airlines. United flies more people to Hawaii than any other airline. That's what friendly skies are all about. This has been an ABC Sports presentation.